Where's my fucking breakfast? Look at that.
Picture perfect.
Good boy. Good boy.
You know, I'll throw this in your lap, and then you have to lick it off
your lap.
I would
still eat it.
I think, I thought I heard the husband's voice this morning outside. I don't know whether it came to the kid or what, because I heard a guy talking to the kid. I didn't hear her scream. Yeah, we got these neighbors that... Wait, did this happen last week? Oh, that's right. So in this vlog, you'll see it. That's right. I forget what day it is. So Monday, I'm editing video for last Tuesday's vlog, right? And Brian's outside with the cats. Well, it's not always like this, but I had my headphones on editing, and so I couldn't hear anything else. And all of a sudden, after a while, Brian comes in and said, "Oh my God, they're fighting upstairs."
He was just kind of shaking his head. I could hear her yelling. He just kind of comes out like, looks at me and goes, "She's crazy." And gets on his bike and rides off.
Yeah, he has it like a 10-speed and gets off and rides off. So, you know, didn't think much about it because she's kind of a yeller. She's been yelling at people since they moved in. We've heard her on the phone yelling about, "Why are you lying to me?" And, you know.
She's one of those people.
They weren't even there. Yeah, they weren't even there 2 weeks until the first time I heard her sitting in the dining area, which is their floor plan is the same as ours. And she had her window open. And you could hear her yelling about, "Why are you fucking lying to me?" Blah, blah, blah. So I'm like, oh, great.
Even when they're both farting with each other, you can't ever hear him. You only hear her, man.
Yeah, it's her. Because she has to be right. It's like the stereotypical woman thing. That, like, women aren't that way. But, you know, when you see one on TV that's a stereotype, that's what she
is.
This one is that. He leaves. Didn't think much about it. And then Wednesday comes along, and I'm in the kitchen, and I hear this knock. And I'm like, that wasn't at our door, because our front doors are right next to each other, you know. And so then I kind of look out the kitchen window. I'm only in my underwear. And I see the cop standing there. I'm like, oh, my God. Like, are they going to knock on my door? Should I get dressed? You know, you get nervous when somebody's at your door. She's talking real normal. Like, can you just tell him this, that? I couldn't tell what she said exactly. I could kind of hear it when I played it back, but she's like, "I just want him to be civil. And when he gets, I just don't want the confrontation." I'm like, bitch, really? Because that's all you are is confrontation. And so anyway, while the cop is standing there, he shows up. And he comes walking up the thing, and he must have come from work because he had on a green shirt and like blue, the khaki dicky type pants, you know, and some emblem was on his shirt. He looked like he was in a uniform. And so I'm eating. So I just kind of sit down thinking, you know, I put my phone in the kitchen window, and I'm thinking, I'll look at it later. Well, he takes out like a bag of stuff, like a a garbage bag of stuff, and also a huge duffel bag that had wheels on it. And then he comes back in, and you could hear her talking. And she's trying to be so civil, and I'm like, you are such a phony, because we hear everything that you say, and this is not how you talk to anybody.
And then yesterday morning, now that he's gone, I hear her on the phone again, obviously talking to the husband, and she's screaming at the top of her lungs, still dropping F-bombs, "You need to be civil! You need to talk to me in a respectful manner!" And I'm like, okay, this is the opposite of what
you're
doing.
It's the irony
right now
of what she's saying, yeah. And the whole thing about it was, that night, when Brian saw everything, they have this 2-year-old boy who's just cute as a bug in a rug, this little blonde-headed kid. They planted a garden out front, and they're teaching him how to water plants the other day, and, you know, he's getting the hang of it and stuff like that. And he's just up there bawling and screaming his eyes out, and this woman is so concerned. This woman scorned is so concerned with telling the guy off and doing whatever, that she's just neglecting the child. If I was him, I would have taken the kid, put him in the stroller, and just walked off. Mm-hmm. You know, and just, because he did the right thing. You know, instead of it escalating more, just get out of the situation for a minute. You know, I don't think they're hitting each other, but if it was domestic, if she started hitting him, it's like, just get out of the house. Keep walking until she's not following you anymore. Right. You know, and so he did the right thing in de-escalating it, but it must have calmed. I kind of feel like he's just tired of it.
He's probably just losing his hearing at this point.
I look at him and he just looks a little bit like,
so
I should have dodged that bullet. I should have just worn a condom. Because really, if they didn't have the kid, they'd probably have no...
Oh, you need
he could be out of there.
All right, let's go.
Yeah, so we're going to go grocery shopping.